Herzlich willkommen zu Musotalk, dem Music- und Sound-Production-Podcast aus Berlin.
Hallo und herzlich willkommen zum Musotalk-Spezial vom Superboost 2016 in Berlin. Jetzt bin ich bei Dave Rossum. Er ist einer der Chefentwickler von Emo gewesen und hat jetzt eigene neue Module auf dem Markt. Hi Dave!
Hi!
You got some new products!
You bet!
Yeah!
Yeah!
So you're trying to ride the modular wave?
Once again!
Yeah, yeah. Because lots of people, they know your heritage is like the EMU systems, you know, and it's more like about sampling for most people. But when we look close, we realize that years before you started doing the samplers, you were really big in the modular business.
That's where we started, with modular systems, and the only reason we got out of them is that there was a period when nobody wanted them.
So
in about 1980, digital was taking off, analog was dying, and we had to get rid of the modular line just because you couldn't even sell them.
So, okay, great.
But now they're, you know, those old systems are worth more than they cost originally, and they were very expensive back then. So,
what I heard or what I read is that you're not reissuing old modules, but you have a lot of new developments, right?
That's exactly right. I'm an inventor at heart, so I'm just really not that interested in just reissuing the old past. But the other part of it is that there's a lot of heritage there that's very valuable. So what we're trying to do at Rossum Electro is take vintage ideas, but bring them forward with something new into the present.
Okay, cool. I'm amazed you checked out a whole range. In quite, how long did you develop them?
So we officially went into business just a little over a year ago, and the first thing we developed was the Evolution analog ladder filter. So that actually came out and went into production just a little over a year after we started. But right on its heels are Control Forge and Morpheus, two digital modules inspired by the Morpheus synthesizer, and those should be out in June.
Okay. Maybe let's take a look at some of this stuff. So you've got a sampler, yeah?
Right. The sampler we're just announcing at the show now. And we're our announcement is we're announcing that we're developing it. So this one doesn't have anything behind it. It's just to show people what it's going to look like and so on.
All right.
It won't be till the end of the summer that we actually have any form of hardware or a little prototype. And we're still really deciding the details of what we're going to do there. We've prototyped some of the stuff mathematically, the phase modulation part of this, which enables you to modulate one sample with another the same way that FM modulated in like the DX7 and things like that. Only here, as far as I know, and nobody's really done this in an instrument before, you can modulate one sample with another in that same manner. And our simulation showed that it sounds really good.
Well, but these days we're into 8 gigabyte, 32 gigabyte samples, RAM. I suppose there's a limit on the amount of stuff you can use here, right?
Yeah, I mean, you know, everything has its place in the computer-based samplers. They've got the wonderful aspect.
You're not trying to get an authentic piano out of this, right?
No. Compared to the days of old, it's probably going to do a pretty decent job of that if you wanted to, but it's going to be nothing like the computer-based sample playback. But that's not what people want. What modular synthesis is really about is that idea of the audio toolkit, that you can just do anything, you can pack anything to anything else. And so this module is designed to give you a maximum amount of real-time flexibility in the sounds that you're using via sampling. So it's essentially a sampling oscillator. It can have great quality, it'll be 24 bits, go up to 96 kHz sample rates. But at the same time, it's got voltage control bit depth. That'll be a real fun feature. We actually prototyped that one as well. And rather than it just switching from 6 to 7 to 8 to 10 to 12, it will actually continuously voltage control that. So we can set it, there is a setting of 7.5 bits or 14.5 bits. Again, we've prototyped that, another one of these things that we know is going to sound good and people will love.
And I assume because you got a whole bunch of gate triggers here, 3 CV outputs, it's multi-voice.
Right, it's multi-timbral, it'll have 8 different voices. Each one is independently configurable. So you're right, we have 3 CV jacks, but what those do for that particular voice will vary however you wanted to set up the voice. Typically you're going to want one of these CVs controlling pitch, but If you're doing a drum machine, maybe you don't want pitch. Okay. You want to control something else. That's fine. You just set it up that way, save it in the program memory, and away you're ready to go.
All right, cool. And your modules are compatible to the 100, the Eurorack system?
Yes, yeah, they're all Eurorack compatible. It's hard to really talk entirely about compatibility because it's sort of a Wild West out there. But we've done our best to make everything capable of talking to everyone.
If I have a 100 system, I can just buy this, put it in, and it will work.
It should just work fine. You shouldn't have any problems. I mean, like I said, since we can't test with every one of the thousands of modules out there, we can't guarantee nobody to have any problems. But it's all carefully designed to be as compatible as we possibly can make it. And I've designed a few things before, so
yes, I remember that. And that's coming back to the Z-Plane filter.
Yes. So this is the module that I'm really excited about. It's the Eurorack implementation of the Morpheus filter. This Z-Plane filter is what we call a 14th order filter. It has seven poles and seven what are called zeros. Zeros are notches, poles are resonances. And we've taken out of the Morpheus, or actually the Morpheus' successor, the Ultra Proteus, a set of 288 sound design filter cubes. A filter cube has eight different filters, one at each vertex of the cube. And in this module, unlike the Morpheus, you can morph in all three of those cube dimensions in real time under voltage control, all the way up to audio rates. We've just gotten sound coming through it in the past week and gotten to really listen to these things. They're totally awesome. I can't find my way around 288 of them yet, but there are a few of them there that I really like. And every time we turn it on and we play with it, discover something new. Oh boy, that sounds really cool as well. We got a lot more work to do to get those ready so that when we ship the module, everybody will have a good sense of how to use them. But it's coming along very well. We're on schedule.
And would you say that the Eurorack system is the standard these days?
It certainly is the popular solution. I mean, there are the 5U units as well, things like that. But Eurorack has just taken off. And we love it because it's become a community of people. And everyone's helping everyone else. We've had a lot of support from other manufacturers. Everyone wants us to succeed. We want everybody else to succeed.
Well, the Germans won the war after all?
You bet.
Hey, great. All right. So how much price and availability? This is not shipping. Obviously, it's still in prototype, alpha, feedback mode.
Right. So the Evolution filter, that's the box right here, and the filter is over here. If we go over to this other rack here, this is an Evolution filter right here. It's an all-analog module. Trust me, it sounds gorgeous. It's just got a wonderful, warm analog sound, as well as the capability because of the genus control here that allows you to switch between the number of poles and the ladder, a unique sound. That is shipping today. It costs $369 in the U.S., you can translate that into euros. It's probably about 390 or 400. They're out in volume. The next two modules, Morpheus and Control Forge, are going to be shipping probably in the month of June, and I would guess towards the end of June. We haven't set final pricing on that, but both of them will be about $500. Okay. Now, in addition to Control Forge, we have the satellite module. This has the same functionality as the Control Forge, but doesn't have the programming built in. So you buy a Control Forge, do all your programming there, then download your presets into one or more satellites. You can now have many times the functionality, not so much space. We haven't set a price on this.
Like an expander.
It's exactly like an expander. So it'll be significantly less than the Control Forge. And again, shipping probably, if not at the end of June, just within a month or so after that.
Sounds great. Thank you very much.
You're welcome.